crazy. So, warm welcome to Potulasoy Towers, and I'm really delighted, and I'm really surprised that people have come from all the places. So again, once again, special welcome to the people who have come from outside. Bhubaneswar, Guwahati. Guwahati is really far. I mean, seriously, very far off from Guwahati. Anybody from Guwahati? Upar. Okay. So, yeah. So, very special welcome to all the people. I think the backdrop is perfect. Market is down 500-600 points. And I think in everybody's mind, it must be going on, what's going to happen, and how to think about this kind of situations. And see, one of the good things about the stock market is that every day is a new day. I mean, you try to think that in 2004 something has happened, or 2008 something has happened, like chartists, they try to find patterns that, okay, in 2008 things have happened like this, so again in 2014 it is going to happen like this, or 2015 it is going to happen like this. So, but I have seen that every time is new time, and the companies which make money in, say, 2000 will not make money in 2015, and the companies which will make money in 2015 will not make money in 2020. So there are always new sets of companies coming in, and new winners, and some of them are also old winners, but clearly market is at one level, and making money is yet another. So I think what we are concerned about is the making money, rather than where is market going to be. Because frankly speaking, I also don't know where the market is headed. In the sense that whether it will go to 7,200, I think I have seen one SMS I got in March from one of my friends whom I was not in touch. And he sent me SMS after maybe 15 years. And he said, I think some 8,500 or something will break and it will go to 7,200. And I just deleted the SMS and forgot it. But suddenly I remembered that that guy was kind of right. So now, but you can't act on these kind of things. I mean, even if somebody says that you go to 7,200, doesn't mean that you must sell tomorrow and wait for 7,200. What happens if by the way it goes to 8,200? So clearly, predicting the market is not my cup of tea. At least we have not operated like that. And making money is very different. In good time, bad time, money will be made. Companies are making money. So, one of the things I would like to tell you all is that conflict, we have to resolve the conflict between short term and long term, because in short term what happens is that markets are very emotional and very irrational, let me tell you. As you take it shorter, market becomes more and more irrational, and on an hourly basis, it is almost 100% irrational. There is no rationality behind 10% move during the day. I mean, what can happen to the company? Nothing has happened, and yet market has moved by 10%. So it is a perfectly irrational. You take to 5 years, it will be, I would say, 80-90%, maybe 95% rational. You take it to 10%, 99.9% rational. And 15-20 years, it is only rational, 100% rational. It is. In fact, it becomes science. It is not anymore art. So, in fact, making money in the short term is an art. Anybody makes money and get away with this 10% move. Buy low and sell high. In 2 days, 3 days, every day, buy low, sell high, buy low, sell high, or sell high and buy low. And you can make crores out of this money, out of this market. It's a more than art. But making money in the longer run is not so much of an art. It's more of a science and discipline. Of course, there is a form of the discipline itself becomes an art, which is what we are practicing. Buy right, sit tight is a science. When you practice it very well, it becomes an art. And it has nothing to do with the short-term movement in the market, but we have to perform in the market only. So market is relevant. But in the short run, I mean, like today, I'm feeling bad for my clients that a lot of people have lost money as a trader or whatever positions they had. But I'm absolutely peaceful. I don't have any issue with whatever happened in the market. If anything, today the people who have come in, they'll buy it cheaper. Because I expect people to sell in 2020. In 2020, whatever is going to the price is frozen in the future. Say 100 rupees. The guys who came, say 2 months back, they bought it, say 50 rupees. Today they are buying at 45, 44, 43. So I am happy for the people who are buying now. Or maybe they'll buy tomorrow or day after when markets are lower, hopefully. Because in 2020, everybody is going to get 100 rupees. Now, can you get it at 20 rupees? I don't know. I mean, definitely one can get it at 41, 42, 43, and there is no way to figure out what is the lowest price going to be. Absolutely no way. And as we said, as it is said, bottoms and tops are for fools and liars. So don't bother about trying to get the lowest price. If by chance you have money to invest it and you really want to invest, see, if you are not cut for a stock market, there is no point. And I am sure today nobody will come. So if you are cut for a stock market and you want to invest, then there is no harm in kind of getting into the market. 1/4, 1/10, 1/20, some amount you must start putting in. Because nobody knows the bottom. So you have to resolve in your mind as an investor. Second thing is difference between investor and trader. Please don't confuse your trading elements with investing. Trading is all about the short term. You are trading only the price. You are not trading values. In the long run, you are only buying values. This is a fundamental difference. Price is what you pay, values are what you get. In short term, you are only changing, you are buying at 100, you want to sell at 105. You don't care whether there is a fire in the factory. You are only concerned with the price movement. So it's all demand and supply. Nothing to do with the underlying company. When you are buying for 10-15 years, the only way you can make money is what happens to the company. If a company doesn't make money, there is no way you can make money. No way. Even if the company is run by God, who is possible God, and a company makes loss, you will not make money. You know that very well. And we have enough examples. Tata Tele Maharashtra Limited makes losses every quarter. So it remains there only. But if TCS from the same group makes lot of money, it is the most expensive company in the market today. So it's not about a Tata, it's about the underlying business, underlying company. So we have to focus on the what business are going to do in the future. So emotionally you have to disconnect from the very short term violent movement of the market, because it clutters mind. It clutters clearly mind. And it's very tough to say that whatever is happening I'll ignore and I'll only focus on fundamentals. But that's what after 35 years I have attained to practice, that I'm not impacted by the short term movements. In fact, I get very disturbed the day on which somebody says that this company which we are expecting 1000 crores profit is going to come, but for some reason profit is going to be only 800 crores or 500 crores. That disturbs me, even if the stock is up. Even if the stock is up. So we have to get this context right. We'll go through some lot of investing frameworks, because you have to think in silos. Like, as I said about short-term, long-term, I talked about value and price. Like that, we'll talk about 15-20 frameworks about the investing. And then after 30-40 minutes of talking, then we'll take the Q&A. Then I'll be able to connect more to see how exactly you are thinking and what we can talk here. So, one of the things is that 100x, when we started doing the study last year, I didn't realize how much, I mean, I'm in the market for last 30-35 years.
People who are standing in the back, we have some space on the 11th floor, 11th, the 12th floors right now. Can you just move on the 11th and 12th floor, because the session is 45 minutes.
You'll just take care of that. So markets have been in bull run for last 30 years. I mean, if you look at the 100x study, we said let's figure out number of companies which have done very well in last 20 years, that's okay. But how well the market has done? So in last 30 years, market is 100x. Market itself, x dividend. So index used to be about 250, 260 in 1984, when I was just about doing my equity research and all. So I lived every single day, but I didn't realize that dumb index itself is up 100 times. And this is x dividend. Come dividend, it is about in 25, 26 years. So index started in 78, 79 at 100, and by 2005, 6 it was 10,000. So in 25, 26 years, the markets are going 100x. And I don't have any reason to believe what has happened in last 25 years would not be broadly repeated in next 25 years. I'm talking about market level. So you are sitting into a market which is, I mean, the only market I could think of is US, which was 16,000 index, which is now, again I think 16,000 now, in 2000. So in 15 years, it is back to where it was. So none of the markets have the power of bull run as that of Indian markets. Because of the sheer size of the market, and I would think the we'll get to what is the reason for this sustained bull run in this country for many, many years to come. What do you take? I mean, what is needed to make money in the market? This book, at the end he says, the summary of the book, is that you need vision, you need courage, and you need patience. So you come to equity markets, all this money is made into the future. It's not about the past. It's not about the present. Because you are paying about 5 lakh crores for TCS. The company makes about 25,000 crores. So at that pace, it is going to take 20 years for the company to make that 5 lakh crores you are paying today. Obviously, it is not going to take 20 years to earn 5 lakhs. It may take 7-8 years. So there is a growth element in that, which is valued into the current price. And the market is saying in the next 7-8 years, it will earn what you are paying today. And after that, whatever it makes in the next 20-30 years is your profit. That's what market is saying. So it's all about the future. You have to calculate. Somebody has to calculate. If you are not calculating, good. I'm sure nobody is calculating like that. But this is how markets work. Silently, market's job is to figure out how much money any company is making. And that's how, like 3 lakh crores for, I don't look at the price, I look at only market cap. 3 lakh crores for Reliance, 2.5 lakh crores for Infosys, 6 lakh crores, 5 lakh crores for TCS, whatever. And what is the profit today? And how much profit it is going to make in the future? Once you're able to get a sense, so it's all about future. Then you need courage. Once you get to see, like I'll tell you, right in front of us, as we are living today, IOC, Indian Oil Corporation, current year, I mean, this quarter itself, it has made 6,000 crores profit, but nobody believes in the profit, as if uska chori ka profit. 6,000 crores profit, into 4, it works on 24, 25,000 crores. Obviously, they are going to make maybe inventory gain and loss and all that. My sense is they'll make anywhere between 15 to 20,000 crores. You can get the entire company for 90,000 crores. And if it makes money at the same place for next 5 years, you'll get more than 1 lakh crore profit in IOC. So it will earn 1 lakh crore and all the factories and plants and refining and all the pumps. So IOC, you cannot fill your petrol in car by going online. So there's no online threat for this. You have to take your car to the petrol pump. I don't think there is any technology to fill your car by online. So there's no online threat to this. Second, there's no Chinese pump. So Chinese guys cannot throw petrol from China and your petrol pump will be filled. You have to go to IOC pumps. So this is now the only threat to this business is, can Reliance come big? Because Reliance is the only guy who can stand up against IOC HDPP. Can Reliance stand up and say, okay, I'll put up 50,000 pumps and I'll take 50% market share? If that happens, then obviously we have to buy Reliance rather than IOC. But I think Reliance is busy, Reliance Jio, and I think they will take some time before they gather the capital. They will come, I'm sure. They will come. But this is the kind of thing. You are getting 5P stock today and nobody wants to buy it. I think their FPO completely crashed. So when you are alone, see, whenever you get a big idea, you are always alone. आप बाजू वाला किसी से पूछ लो, किसी को पसंद नहीं आ रहा हूं मैं क्या बात कर रहा हूं. आई एम वेरी लोनली. सो वी आर गोइंग टू मेक मनी आवर सेल्फ. वी डोंट वांट टू शेयर मेकिंग मनी विद एनीबडी. बिकॉज एज स्टॉक स्टार्ट्स गोइंग अप, मोर एंड मोर पीपल विल कम. अभी अकेला चल रहा है, पीछे बाद में आएंगे लोग. यू नो दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन यू कैन सी. आई मीन आई एम नॉट आफ्टर भारती, दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम गेटिंग एन आइडिया. इन 2003 in Bharti, I could see that this company is going to make 28,000 crores. They actually made 32,000 crores in 5 years. And the stock was available for 5,000 crores. So you get very rarely a large opportunity. Now, I could be wrong, but what happens is the downside is limited. Because 1 lakh crore is their book value itself. And uske upar se 1 lakh crore kamane wala hai. एक करोड़ एक लाख नहीं कमाएगा तो ठीक है, 50,000 कमाएगा, 60,000 कमाएगा, तो भी पैसा कैसे नहीं टूटेगा आपका? आपका पैसा नहीं टूट सकता. अभी 2 गुना होगा, 4 गुना, 5 गुना होगा, अपना पेट बहुत बड़ा है उसे. 10 गुना होगा तो और कम है, 20 गुना होगा तो और भी कम है ना. ऐसा खरीदना चाहिए. सी व्हाट इज बफेट साहब मेन रूल नंबर 1, डोंट लूज मनी. कभी पैसा कमाने का नहीं भैया. रूल नंबर 2, डोंट फॉरगेट रूल नंबर 1. कभी भूलने का नहीं. लोग क्या होता है, जैसे जैसे बाजार बढ़ते जाते हैं लोग भूलते जाते हैं. अरे अभी तो हम बना ही लेंगे पैसा, हम जैसा बोलते हैं ऐसे होता बाजार. ऐसा नहीं होता है. यू हैव एवरी स्टेप हैज टू बी वन बाय वन, वन बाय वन, वन बाय वन. नेवर लूज द फोकस ऑफ व्हाट कैन बी द डाउन साइड. सो यू हैव टू हैव विजन, यू हैव टू सी द फ्यूचर. एंड इट्स नॉट अबाउट द डिग्री, what degree you have, whether you have studied in IIM Ahmedabad, whether you are an IITian. If the attitude is there to see the future, even a matriculate guy or simple BCom guy can also see the future of some businesses, some companies. So you need to see the future, you have courage to buy it, and then hold it. Nothing happens in a year or two. Big money is made only if you hold it for long period. And this is a market, if you buy good company, hold it for long period. Downside is limited, upside is not unlimited, but literally unlimited. We'll come to that. What is investing? Are you seeing one by one you start getting the frameworks to how to think about particular thing? Investing is consuming more, gaining more consumption power in the years ahead for your money, what you save today. See, if you have saved a crore, you should be able to buy 10 crore worth of stuff after 10 years. So inflation adjusted, you should be able to increase your purchasing power for your money. So what is the biggest enemy? Inflation. That is the first battle you have to buy. Now, inflation for last 34 years is at 8.25%. This is a crazy economy, very inflationary. High growth, high inflation. So it's a crazy country, very inflationary. So your 100 rupees in 1978-79 has become 5.5 rupees after 34 years. So you will not find anybody who will tell you that my grandfather left me a fixed deposit of 1 crore and I have become very rich. Have you heard this story? But you'll find a lot of guys, and probably some of the lucky guys are sitting here, that his dad left 1,000 shares of Hindustan Unilever, bought at 25 rupees, and today I don't know how to consume that. Or 1,000 Wipro shares, or 1,000 Infosys. I used to stay in a paying guest where this old lady, her husband had left 100 shares of 100 rupees paid up value of Bajaj Auto. I'm talking about 83, 84. She was, her son was a doctor in Lingland, but she used to go to London every year by selling few shares of Bajaj Auto. And she used to run her house on the dividends of Bajaj Auto. And she used to keep two or three paying guests, only chartered accountants, so that her portfolio can be managed free of cost. She was a wonderful lady. So, you know, this is the power of a widow who was literally, I would not say illiterate, but literally she didn't have any, she was a wonderful lady, nice person. But few good stocks can take you through the life. And she was not dependent on her son. In fact, her son was a wonderful doctor, but he was not as rich as the lady when she died. You know? So this is the power of investing in equities diligently. Look at how the asset classes have done. Three-year fixed deposit, that is up in 34 years by 18 and a half times. You would think you have made a lot of money. 18 times is a good number. Gold is up 38 times. So all the ladies here, they must be very happy. Yes, they have done very well. Then the stocks, they are up to whatever, 27,000, 25,000 now. This is ex-dividend. If you put 1.5% dividend, it goes to 47,000. And if you put 1 or 2% of active performance, little superior performance by the manager, it will go to literally 1 lakh. Stocks are up, little better managed, stock portfolios are up 1,000 times in 34 years. Literally 1,000 times. Now if you adjust it for the inflation, which is your biggest enemy, your fixed income 100 is at 100. Inflation is post-tax. Your fixed income return is pre-tax. To equate the 8.5% post-tax return, you need to get 11.5% pre-tax return across entire portfolio and all the time. You can get one FMP on a 10% of your portfolio for some period, but on a 10-15 years across the portfolio, to get a post-tax 8% is difficult, almost impossible. Gold is about 2 times and stocks are about X dividend about 15 times, come dividend more like 25 to 27 times. It means we must have some portion of our savings in equities. Some portion definitely must be there. So this is the question we used to answer when markets were at 9,000. Market has gone up, why invest now? Now the question is, market has gone down, why invest now? Isn't it? Because the people who don't want to invest, going up is also a problem, going down is also a problem. Basically, they don't want to invest. You have to decide what you want to do. See, all the people who had not invested, they went to the God and they said, sir, bring it down so that we can buy. So God has given you this great opportunity. You must do. Market down. But they are saying that, sir, aapne bahut gira diya, ab abhi nahi khareedenge. You know, so I think the problem is that when do you want to buy? So one manager says, so what's your bull market? I'm not afraid of next 10, 15, 20% decline. I'm afraid of missing next 100% uptake. Focus on what is possible in the next 5-7 years. Don't focus on next, what can happen in the next 3 days, 5 days, 1 month, nobody is any clue. Even if Lord Shiva comes to you in the night, on his own, and tells you tomorrow market is going to go up by 1000 points, don't believe him. He doesn't know. Nobody knows. Probably some chartist. But chartists are right looking back, not looking forward. You know, out of 10 chartists, one chartist is definitely right. But that you will come to know after 5 months who is right. So basically don't focus too much on the, what is going to be the, if you believe that 5-10 years henceforth you will be better off, you have to go and buy. Otherwise you will just miss. The great long-term risk of stocks is not owning them. What is the right time to buy? The right time to buy is when you have the money, and the right time to sell is when you need the money. So it is right time to buy is now. I mean, that's how I practice. I tried everything. Let the market go a little down. Let me do a little averaging. Nothing works. At the end of it, you get today's price only. So why sweat for next 10 days and get today's price? Better be done with, do some other work. I think you'll be better off. Then comes this, how much should I invest? So everybody starts like this, slowly. It's like getting into swimming pool when you don't know swimming. You start with 1 foot, then 2 foot, then 3 foot. So you start with 5%. If it works, I'll put another 10%. If it works very well, then 20%. Then right at 50,000 next, people will put last 50%. What happens? There is nobody behind you. And then market crashes. So you will have a very bad experience. You know, I used to do like this for 20 years. There's nothing new. The way it flows is like this. If you have decided, if you have a crore and you want to put money into the market, tomorrow morning, do your prayer, do your puja paath, 9:15, write the check. You are done. It's like taking a dip in Haridwar. Go anytime, it is very cold. Till you buy the stock, till you are sitting in cash, it will be very uncomfortable to you. The moment you take the dip, you become very fresh. It's like that here. Maybe it will fall. Don't worry about 5-10% fall after you buy. In fact, you pray to the God, the moment you buy, let the market fall by another 10%. So that it is done. See, because you can't be, market is your servant, mind you one thing. Market is your servant, it is not your malik. It is your servant. If you treat it as your servant and then don't bother about what he is doing, you are better off. If you think he is your malik and you have to obey his command, then you are in mess. You know, because he is a drunk guy. Somebody is up, somebody is down, you go crazy. So you have to know how to handle the temperament of Mr. Market. The best way is to gather at best. See, if you are worried, I mean, it looks very simple for me to tell, but one of the ways you can do it is that, okay, markets are down enough, I want to get into the market, but I'm not courageous enough like Ramdev. So let me make it in 3 installments, 4 installments, 12 installments. Then market is gone. For next 1 year, you keep putting every month. I mean, you get an average of 12 months. You're done. Yes, ma'am. Pardon? Pardon? Cracking? Yeah. Okay. Is it better? Yeah. Yeah. So, lower the thing. Yeah. Now, what do you want to buy? See, quality and valuation. This is the biggest problem right now. What is happening is that there is a lot of thinking about very expensive stocks. Quality is always expensive, let me tell you. In every walk of life, you go to buy cashew nuts. Cashew nuts, the normal ones will cost you, say, 400 kg. As the size of the cashew nuts keep growing, for the same 1 kg, you may have to pay as high as 3 times or 4 times. And once you crush it, there is no difference. Probably the smaller one is better. Okay? So in stock market, it is not so. Actually, it is just the reverse. The higher quality stocks actually are much better. They earn more, they live longer. They make a lot of money in the long run. You cannot count how much money they make in 50, 60 years of their useful existence. So 99% of the problem in the portfolios, they come because of low quality stocks entering your portfolio simply because they are cheap. They are the most expensive ones. They are good for trading. And 90% of the companies listed, they are not good for long-term investing. So we have decided we will give only quality in our portfolios. That's why the first name Q. High quality stocks. They are expensive. Our portfolio will definitely be more expensive than other portfolios. Even at least compared to the index, it will be expensive because they are much higher in quality. Low quality, the problem is that they are good for investing only when they are very cheap. That is when the indices are absolutely pathetically low. But at that point of time, nobody wants to buy. And if you buy low quality, necessarily you have to sell when the price goes back. But in high quality stocks, even if you don't sell at high price, you are not going to be cleaned up. Market will give up. Look at Nestle today. Everything has gone wrong with Nestle. Their biggest brand is out of the shelf. They have incurred first loss in 30 years. When the product will come back in shelf, nobody knows. Still the stock is 6,000. If you have a million shares, you can sell it. This is the only stock which is outperforming today. This is for the quality. If by chance Nestle was growing at 20%, which is the normal pace, if nothing had gone wrong, I'm quite sure Nestle would have been today 7,500 or 8,000 rupees. Even in bad market. That's the power of quality. So we must build quality portfolio. And that's what we help in. We will not give you bad quality portfolios. Even if it is a good thing, we'll not give you. Because we know you'll be trapped. So we wanted to find how to pick quality companies at low prices. So in last wealth creation study, we did 100x study. So what is 100x? The companies which have gone at least 100 times in last 20 years. Minimum 100 times, not maximum. Minimum 100 times. So Asian Paint has done 106 times in last 20 years, between 94 and 2004. This we have spoken. So these are the companies, 47 companies between 94 and 2014. Infosys up 2,900 times in last 20 years. Lupin is up 1,170 times. And these are the March 14 cutoff. If you take this entire company as a basket between 14 and now, again they are up by 40-50%. All of them. These are companies which have done well. And almost all the stories, they have come here. Whether it is Madhusudan Swami, Wipro, Sri Cement, Kotak Mahindra Bank, Kimami, Aisha Motor, all of it is there. All the known big stories are there. Asian Paint 106 times. So what is required to pick this kind of companies? How do you get high quality company which is going to perform big way? So our findings are, you need SQGLP. QGLP is our normal process, quality goes longevity, reasonable price. But if you want to make a lot more money, at times you get these ideas. That is, you have to buy them young, when they are small. It may not be young, but they have to be necessarily small. So what happens is, the size has to be small and relatively unknown. If you are small and very popular, then like what is happening with the dot-com companies, they are very small, they are not even making money, but the prices are running into billions. There you cannot do 100x. Even if the company goes 100x, you will not make a lot of money, for sure. So you need small, and 80% of, see, you need about 2,000-3,000 crores maximum. 400-500 crores, very good, but you can go as high as 2,000-3,000 crores. Because in next 10, 15, 20 years, the size of the economy will be, it's the size of the economy in next say 20 years will be almost, I would think, almost 7 to 8 times will be size of the economy itself. And hence, companies which will be successful, the largest company will be like 20 lakh, 30 lakh crores. The largest company today is 5 lakh crores. In 15 years, it will be more like 15 to 20 lakh crores will be single company. So a company which is starting today, and most likely that company is not born. Or the company is somewhere 1,000 to 2,000 crores, 3,000 crores. Which company that will be, I don't know. But that company is very small right now. So, because what is happening is, it keeps happening, every 20 years, the list of the large companies, they keep changing. If you see in 80s, I mean, I have lived that, it used to be all the cotton textile mill of Kohinoor, Standard Mills, they used to be then A group. Century, I mean, till about 94, Century used to be the company. Today, these companies are nowhere. The companies are demolished, they have premises. I think this company is also, this building where you are sitting, this was Crown Mills, one of the large mills here. It is, you are sitting on here, companies are gone. This is only 30 years. Then 90s were, 90s I think it was a boom of tech companies. You know, suddenly from nowhere, Infosys, Wipro, all these companies came. And they became 1 lakh crore company. I mean in 94, Infosys came at 31 and a half crores. In June 93, they did IPO, which flopped at 31 and a half crores. And by 2000, in 7 years, it became 1 lakh crore. Okay? Now, Sun Pharma came in 98 to 97, which was, I mean, I think 700-800 crores market cap. Today, now Sun Pharma is running the world. I mean, all the pharma companies are becoming very large. Lupin was a sick company in 98 to 2001. Literally sick company, few hundred crores. Now it is running into 40-50,000 crores kind of market. So you are going to see winners getting born right in front of you. So you need to identify what was there. Then it has to be relatively unknown when you spot it. Then you look at the quality of business. See, what is the quality? This is where exactly that was for small companies. But here, what is the quality of business? You need more. You need a business where there is a massive entry barrier. The opportunity is very large. But what is that, if I come with money today, what it takes for me to enter? Where is the difficulty? The difficulty index will decide how much money the guy is going to make and how long it is going to make. So you need the companies with a lot of entry barriers. See, United Spirits, it may not be making money today, but it's a country where you are not allowed to advertise liquor. They own 55% of the share, and party in this country is yet to start. So how much liquor they are going to sell? And how much money they are going to make? Again, Chinese guy, you don't want to get drunk online. There's no way you can get drunk digitally. You know, you have to consume the liquor. There is no Chinese brand here. So you have to, now you cannot build a brand of that size. So obviously these guys are going to have license to make money. Unless government says you cannot make money. So you need to find quality of business, fantastic quality of business. Then second is quality of management. It is as important. But first thing is quality of business. Tata Tele Maharashtra Limited has bad business but terrific management. Zero multiplied by one is equal to zero. 1 multiplied by 0 is 0. So you have to get terrific business run by terrific management. Once you get this to right, you are licensed to kill in the marketplace. Nothing can stop you, whether you make less money or more money. That's only a matter of time. At what price you buy, how much time you stay, how much it grows, that's a little later. But if you are terrific business run by terrific management, no, I can almost guarantee you, literally, I can guarantee that you will make money. What I can't guarantee is how much money you make. And what is management? Good management? Management with competence, management with passion, but most importantly, management with integrity. In India, all the managements are competent. They are very passionate because this is first generation. But very few are with a high integrity. There are few. But they're fantastic management, Infosys, Wipro, Tata's. I mean, there are a whole lot of managements which are amazing. So you have to be able to see very clearly that these businesses are run by terrific guys. Then growth. Understanding growth is very, very important. And every company is distinctly different in growth trajectory. Like if there are three broking companies, like Motilal Oswal, Edelweiss, or IFL, all three have a different business model. All three can be called broking companies. But how they will shape up in the next 5-7 years is a very different thing. We are evolved in different way, we do different things, our competences are different, and the outcomes will also be different. Very different. We don't have any loans. We have 50% cash. Somebody has 5 times in loans, 10,000 crores, 15,000 crores. So they are pursuing different businesses. I'm not saying what they are doing is wrong or anything like that, but they are different. So within same industry, you have to understand, like Sri Cement. Sri Cement is another cement company. But out of 40 companies, Sri Cement is 100 times in the last 10 years, rest of the companies are staying there only. And quite a few of them are gone sick. So you have to understand growth trajectory of every company. And that's a lot of question mark. I mean, you have to understand the sales growth, you have to understand the realization growth, you have to understand the reduction in cost of production, you have to understand how the finance will work. So all put together, you have to understand the growth in the earnings. Another question comes up in growth is that, should you buy growth companies? See, what happens is, people are not able to differentiate between good company and bad company. But people can, with their eyes, they can see, this company is growing at 50%, some company is not growing. Now, when you have only growth, without quality, it's a growth trap. Because what happens is, Unitech, it grew like mad. Satyam, it grew like mad. But there was no quality, there was no base. The whole edifice collapsed. And all the people, I mean, all put together, minority shareholders as a whole, put together, they lost money. Like MTech Auto now. It has created so much of chaos in an industry where Bharat Forge is going every day new high. And this guy is crashing. Why? It's happening right in front of us. And it's not like 100 guys are competing, there are only 2-3 guys. So, you have to get high quality growth, but high quality. Now you have Colgate, Hindustani, but they are very high quality, but they are very expensive. So they are also not doing that well. Colgate has underperformed the index in last 20 years. Colgate has grown at 12-13%, whereas 12-14% is fantastic, but index has done 18%. So if you want to beat the index, Colgate is not going to beat the index. So you need quality as well as growth. QG. You have to necessarily buy Q, that is non-negotiable, but if you want to make serious money, you have to buy G within Q. So Q and G both are required. So that deep blue, right hand top, that's where your portfolio should be standing. And not one or two. All the stocks, if you have 15 stocks in your portfolio, 15 stocks in your portfolio, 5 stocks in your portfolio, you have to have QG. Otherwise you will not make serious money. That's the one which we do for you. While you look at every single stock, if you think it is not a quality, it doesn't have growth, please let me know. I will be the first person to know it. Then the longevity. We are not talking about quality or growth of 1 or 2 years. We are talking about 10, 15, 20 years. Because market is a time machine. See, actually market is like Shiva. It has a third eye, which can see the next 25, 30 years and can give you valuation today. This is the only most wonderful machine where you present yourself and it will say, like for Motilal Oswal, it is giving a valuation of 4,000 crores, but we make only 200 crores or 150 crores. So market is telling you that in next 10, 15, 20 years, this company is going to make a lot of money. But that's what market is saying. I'm not saying so. So you need growth and quality for not 1 or 2 years. You need the quality and growth for next 10, 15 years, 20 years, 30 years. Longer. See Nestle. Nestle will be there after 50 years also. It is the largest consumer company in the world and amongst the oldest. Your milk products, your chocolates, and a whole lot of things. They are going to be there. At least that has been there for the last 200 years. I don't see what can replace it. So you need the longevity. So QGL and then price. See, price is the easiest. Every single guy knows here what is the price of any stock. In your pocket you have a smartphone that can give you the price of any stock anywhere in the world right now. So price is the easiest thing to know. What is most difficult is the value. QGL is about the value. Value is what you get, price is what you pay. So you know only the price, you don't know the value. And value is lot of discipline, lot of practice. And you pay to any manager, me or anybody else, for determining the right value, not the right price. Price is in nobody's hands. Price is nobody's hands, you cannot predict. But you can predict the value. What is in your control is how much you are buying, what you are buying. So once the price value gap is there, you have to buy and hold on. So that becomes buy right, sit tight, you know, and the power of portfolio approach. Now here what happens is you might get one stock right, but it's very dangerous, because if you are wrong, then you can be cleaned up. And once you go down, nobody bothers about you. If you have 10 crores and 90% gone, you become very small guy. To come back from 1 crore to 10 crores, you need 9 times more work. So it's a lot of work. You might never be able to make it up in life. So what is important is to protect the downside. You must never lose. This market is, you can lose a lot of money, because this is not a gold market where you cannot lose anything. I mean, in gold market, you buy it, say, you buy it, anywhere you go, you get 24 karat gold. And if gold goes down by 4-5%, you can lose that much only. But this market, like you have an M-Tech auto, if by chance your portfolio is made up of only M-Tech auto, imagine what can happen to you. So it is very important that you go through portfolio approach. In portfolio approach, what happens is, maximum loss you can have on a stock is 1x or less than that. One or less. We went wrong in financial technologies. We bought at 1000, sold at 150. So we lost almost 80% in 6 months. This is the biggest disaster I have ever had in my life. But yes, we lost 3-4%, 5%. 5% we allocated, 4% we lost. But in the same year, I bought iShare at 2000, which went to 8000 in 1 year. What happened? It got counterbalanced. In fact, in that year, if you have made portfolio of 5 rupees of this, 5 rupees of that, you would have doubled the money, despite the disaster. That's the power of portfolio. So downside is limited, upside can be much, much higher. So you must operate in portfolio. And portfolio has to be very well balanced. So how do you balance a portfolio? So, you know, this is the average return of about 52%. You see, this is a live portfolio of one of the portfolios, F35. So this is how the portfolios were looking a month back. So you know, 1/3 of the portfolios done very well. You see that top 5, 6, 7 stocks. This is a real portfolio, just a month back. Then you have the blank ones, which are averaged about 50-52%. Then there are 4 companies, State Bank of India, Supreme, Hero Motocorp, TCS. They're all wonderful companies, but they're grossly underperformed. So we didn't buy these companies, 4 companies, knowing that it is going to underperform. But this has happened, and yet the average return of the portfolio is 52%. But actually, the return of the entire portfolio is 62%, 64%. Why? You see, the first one is 9.5%, 2%. This is what is maximum allowed by SEBI. And the lowest guy is 1%. So when you play with the weights, you get another 1/3, 25% return. So you have to get the stocks right, you have to get your allocations right. So portfolio approach is very important. And well-balanced, well-articulated, balanced portfolios are what actually maximizes the return and reduces the risk. Basically, one of the first things investing in equity is to reduce the risk. The downside possibility has to be cut, at least the permanent downside. We cannot stop when the markets went down by 6%, our portfolios also went down by, say, 5.5%, 4-6%, which is I mean, short term you cannot control, but as you go along, they recover very quickly. So why we are so excited about India?
My God.
So why are we excited about India? So India is the next trillion-dollar opportunity. What happens is that it took 60 years for the nation to reach a trillion-dollar GDP, $1,000 per capita. It took just about 7 years to go to 2 trillion. Now the next trillion-dollar will come in 5 years, and fourth will come in 3 years, and fifth will come in 2 years. Now what is the importance of this? See, when you're $1,000 per this, we must get it very clearly. And this is why the story of bull run is to be believed in India. At $1,000, your discretionary spend is only $100. $900 is essential. There is no role of any company. Basic food, basic transport, basic living, there is no role of the corporate at all. And if corporate is not supplying anything, you cannot make money. What is there for the stock market? But when you go to $2,000, your basics remain at 1,000, but discretionary is go to 1,000. So what is the doubling of GDP? Is 10 times for the exponential business opportunity. Like car. You see, today Mercedes, BMW and Audi, they are growing at 25-30%, when the industry itself is growing at 2-4%. And motorcycle, two-wheeler is actually declining right now, or maybe flat. So the discretionary spend is growing very, very rapidly. So you have to buy, in this situation, the businesses which are going to grow. So winning categories. Which are the categories which are going to win? So people are going to paint more, people are going to buy more cars, people are going to buy more fashionable tiles, whatever. So you have to buy the winning categories. Then within that, category winners. One is a growing business, and within that, the companies which are going to win. Like if you are buying paints, then Asian Paint is going to win the game. You know, so like that, if you find 18-20 categories and all the leaders which are going to win those businesses, you put in the portfolio with the proper allocations, you have a nice portfolio. That's how we go about building your portfolios. Now, so it is very important that India has that journey going for the next $1 trillion. And my sense is, in 98, China was $1 trillion, where we reached in 2008. So India is just 10 years behind China. And whether Modi sahab or Rahul Baba, India will reach, you know, where China is today in 10 years or maybe 12 years. So we have, and this happens once in a lifetime for the country. It happens only once in a lifetime. So this is a very opportune time. This time is not going to be repeated. Like China is suffering now. India will suffer, but it will suffer after 15 years. It will suffer, but first we'll do the journey of $8-10 trillion. And this is the $1 trillion opportunity which you have. You invest now, I think in next 10, 12 years, I mean, if instead of 10 years, it takes 12 years or 13 years, but this story is bomb one. As far as the market outlook is concerned, now coming to the markets, see, markets are today depressed. Of course, the macro, whatever is happening, global sell-off, but today's valuations are depressed because corporate profit to GDP, the corporate profits are depressed. Today, all the people who are supplying capital, all the banks, all the savers, they're getting a lot of interest. Nowhere in the world you can get 8%, 9% for your savings. Nowhere. I mean, typically in Europe and America, literally nobody bothers where the money is lying. Because you get 0.5%, 0.25% for your savings in US and all. So to get here 8-9% is like, it is not going to continue. It is going to come down. And as the interest cost comes down, businesses will prosper. And again, most likely will go from 4% to hopefully 6-8% in the years to come. So right now, the depressed earnings are discounted at depressed P multiples. So interest rates are at about now 7.8 or something. It must plunge to at least 5%, if not more. It will happen. Whether it happens in 1 year or 2 years, only time will tell, but this is bound to happen. Once interest rate comes down, you see the profits will take a lot of time to come back. But the expectation of profit growth will take the market up. And hence, whenever interest rate declines happens, market will respond very quickly. Profit will not respond. It will take 1 or 2 years for the profit to come. But markets will move ahead of time. So market cap to GDP, this number is not mistake. It is at about 67% right now. At the peak, this number was 180%. And that number will come someday, I'm telling you. In next 5, 6, 7 years, that number will come. So we are buying at about 67%. Maybe 10% more it can go down. That's it. So your downside is 10%, upside is 120%. Of the rising GDP. So in next 6 years, if GDP doubles, and your market cap to GDP goes 3 times, you literally are sitting 6 times upside and 10% downside. And I'm talking about the market. If you have a brilliant fund manager, probably you are sitting onto maybe 10 times upside and 20%, 15-20% downside. And that will be temporary. For sure it will be temporary. I'll be surprised if index is here after 12 months. So this is coming from the experience, I'm not trying to, but I mean nobody knows the this thing, but the downside is very limited. I mean of course, if every single FIs they say that we don't want to see the face of India and we want to take back an entire 200 billion, I think even in that situation, I'll be surprised if market goes back to even 6,000. There are enough savings in the country that will buy out entire FIs at a particular price. So I think we are sitting in a very interesting, the market is poised currently at a terrific juncture. Even the worst of the your charters now, they are not talking about below 7200. So how much is the gap? Kitna raha? What is the next rate? 7600, 7700, kitna raha?
76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76. 76.
foreign funds were, I mean, the worst, which is not even 10%, which is only 5, 6, 7%. I mean, I don't know. I mean, this looks to be a crazy kind of deal. So how do we find billing companies that I told you SQGLB process full? Now, this thing I would like to tell you. When you understand growth, you have to look at the compounding. Nothing is simple investing. Everything is kagar. Now, you understand rule of 72, how to figure out how many years it takes to double. You know, rule of 72 is if you divide 72 by number of years, you get the percentage at which it will double your money in those many years. If you divide 72 by percentage, you get the number of years in which your money will double. So this simple rule has to be known. Very few people know it, very few, and even fewer people practice it. So it's not about, so you have to figure out if something grows at 25% for 10 years, 1 rupee will become 10 rupees. But that is half the job. What you have to figure out is how much money it is going to make in next 10 years. That is summation of compounding. That's the next level. So do you know a company which grows at 25% for 10 years, that in it becomes 42 times. And at times, you can get these kind of companies for 5, 10 rupees, 10 P multiple, 15 P multiple. When the companies are small, nobody knows. They are growing at 30%, 40%. You can buy at 15 P. So basically, if the company grows for 10 years at 25% also, it is going to make 42 rupees. And if you can get it for 10, 12 rupees, you are going to make in any case 4, 5 times, plus the company after that. So clearly, you have to know the maths of growth and summation of growth. So now, I think this is what about what we do. And we have practiced this in 6 products: Value PMS, Next Generation Opportunity, and India Invest Strategy. There are 3: large cap, mid cap, multi cap strategy, and then you have 3 mutual fund products. So this is the oldest strategy. This is where you must focus. What is possible? In 13 years, the strategy is up 21 times. and market is up 8 times. It's not that it has gone in a straight line. There are times in 2005-06 when it didn't do well. It didn't do as well as whole index. Index did, I think, 40% in 2006. We did about 24-25%. So there are periods when we also underperform. But in performance, underperformance is good. You know, in good times, if you underperform, there's no problem. But you must get performance. This is how it looks in terms of more recent performance. 1 year is, see, 1 year, year on year, we are down to zero in terms of index. This strategy is up 23%. I don't know which date is that. 20 strategy inception. I think this must be 1 or 2 days old, maybe yesterday's. So it is up 23%, market is flat. 2 years, 40%, market is 20%. Now 13 years, 27.5% and 18% market. And this is after the fees. This is a wonderful strategy, mid-cap strategy, which came at the peak of the market, and it is up almost 4 times, whereas the index is up only 50%. Because this came in December 2007, nothing can be worse time than this one. You see how it has done. In 1 year, it is up 56% against 7.5% for the market. On 5 year basis, it is up 27% against 8.5%. And since beginning, from the peak of last quarter, market is up 5%, this is up 20%. Nothing can be worse than the negative. Then the products, which is mutual fund products, is F25 large cap, which is up about 22% against 12% of. See, these are the only products we have. See, it is not that I am showing you 6 good products out of 40. No, there are only 6 products. See, when you see my competition, they will show you 3 good products as well as this. But those 3 products are out of 40 products. They don't show the 37 junk. This is good, bad, only everything. There's no other product. Focus 30, this is a mid-cap strategy. Double when the market is up 1.5 times or something like that. 60% compounded against 41%. And then this is the flagship F35 multi-cap. This is up about 52% compounded in last 15-16 months against 19% for the market. So this is about 30% outperformance. See, this kind of outperformance you cannot get away with. That's why I'm saying don't focus on the short terms. But this one, this is to be believed, because this is 13-year-old strategy. You can do magic in 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, but 13 year is very tough. Because it has seen one bull run and between 2003 to 2008, and then from 2008 to 2015, all the bear market. So it has 4, 5, 6 years of good time and same 6, 7 years of bad time. So it has good balance. So you can make 27-28%, but don't look at this number. Please come with the expectation of only 15%. Because these are all past. Future, there is no guarantee. But we are better. We can probably do better. But I would not ask you to come looking at this number that this will come. I will not even say 15.5%. If 15% makes you happy, come here. Keep the expectation low. Whatever comes, it's in your pocket. Okay, so with this, I think we'll close the remarks. And as you know, all our network, all the network of myself, Mudilalji, and the company itself, the listed companies, half the money is put into these products. So 100% of the money is in these products. I don't have charge to jump, you have a charge to jump. But come, join the, what do you call it, the process, and let's make money together. Okay, thanks very much.